You're entering the zone. ABC4's Red Zone.
It's been a tough first month for the Utah gymnastics team. The schedule has been as brutal as the winter weather. The Red Rocks have faced top-ranked UCLA, 7th-ranked Georgia, and number 9 Nebraska. And tonight, it's the number 2 team in the country, the Stanford Cardinal. Utah has beaten each of those top 10 teams, but tonight's matchup could be its toughest one yet. Another huge crowd is expected in the Huntsman Center to watch two of the best collegiate gymnastics teams in the country go at it. It's number 4 Utah versus number 2 Stanford, and it's coming up next. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Huntsman Center. Site of tonight's college gymnastics meet between 4th-ranked Utah and number 2 Stanford. Wesley Ruff alongside former University of Utah gymnast and former Olympian Missy Marlowe. Missy, Utah's had a brutal January schedule so far.
Well, they've come through it with flying colors. I tell you what, 3-0 against all top 10 teams. Now, tonight might be a different story. I've been watching warm-ups for the last 2 hours, and both of these teams are fantastic. Stanford is on the money. Their release moves are high. Their tumbling's up through the roof, and they're very spirited, and they want to come here and win. Utah, of course, has won the last 7 in a row at home. They don't want Stanford to come in and ruin anything, so it'll be a good competition tonight.
But Utah has some problems because the injury bug has bitten and bitten hard. Jacqueline Johnson will miss tonight's meet because she has a concussion. And, of course, Kendall Robards, the senior, injured her knee during warm-ups last week at Nebraska. Earlier this week, Gail Mackey talked about the injury situation.
Not having her there, it's like she's the rock, and we always look to her for leadership and, you know, being solid and stuff. But at the same time, like, injuries do happen, and we know that, and so we always make sure that our alternates are ready to go and our second alternates are even ready to go for cases like this.
So with all of the injuries here, Missy, the freshmen on this Utah team will be counted on heavily to perform well here tonight against Stanford.
They will. They've been counted on heavily all season long, which is really unusual for the University of Utah. Usually it's the upperclassmen, and the underclassmen have a really kind of a long haul ahead of them to break into that. This year, 15 tonight, 15 of the 24 routines will be competed by freshmen. So far, they have been stunning in the first 3 meets.
Interesting to see how well they perform here tonight against the number 2 team in the country. It's Utah versus Stanford. College gymnastics at its best. And it's coming up next. Back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. Utah versus Stanford in college gymnastics. And Missy, Utah starting on the vault, as they always do here at home. And 5 freshmen competing in the 6 rotations.
I don't know if that's ever happened to Utah. We'll have to check the archives. That might be a first. You know, they've earned it. I mean, they're doing a good job. It is a really big loss to not have Kendall in. As much as they're trying to downplay it and have to downplay it mentally, you know, as far as the vault lineup goes, she's the best in the country. So
number 1.
Right. So, you know, I mean, you can't say that it doesn't affect your team, but they're strong. I mean, she has a good chance of coming back this season. So what this will really do is give those young ladies in the 4th and 5th and 6th spots a chance to, you know, they're going to have to fight it out and see who gets to keep their spot in the lineup if Kendall recovers in time.
And we'll see how well they do against Stanford, the number 2 team in the entire country. This should be a great meet here tonight.
It's going to be fun.
Leah Del Piore, one of the freshmen going here for Utah. She'll be leading things off, taking the place of Jacqueline Johnson in the leadoff position in the vault.
First vault, round off back handspring, layout full twist, and she piked that Yurchenko down just a little bit, resulting in the large hop backwards. There's the round off entry, full twist, and again, the judges want to see the gymnast stay completely stretched until the very last minute before the feet make contact with the floor.
First gymnast competing for the Cardinal tonight, Shelly Alexander, and she will be the only all-arounder for Stanford here tonight. Actually, there are 3 all-arounders. My bad.
Stanford had a fantastic warm-up on the bars. Very impressive. Their handstand positions are absolutely perfect. High releases, nailing their dismounts. They'll be tough to beat on bars. A full pirouette to a tuck double back. Again, not one of the harder dismounts we'll see, but stuck cold, and it had no deductions, and sometimes that's the name of the game.
And now we get our first look of the season at Victoria Shanley, one of the freshmen here on the Utah team.
Leo's vault. Here you see the round off back handspring. The judges are looking for the maximum possible expulsion off the horse.
Welcome to Utah Gymnastics. If you're going to have a debut, that's a pretty good one to have right there, isn't it?
I'll say.
Danielle Ecoma now on the bars for Stanford.
He has a career and a season best of 9.725. There's a Weiler kip to a Jaeger. Ooh, and that was really close into the bar. She did a good job not having to take an extra swing on her shoot half over low bar. Caught in just a little bit close. Giant swing, giant. Double layout and a step on the landing. You know, she kept her form well, so not really obvious, but that Jaeger was really in close to the bar. Had a lot of bent elbows. That's a big deduction.
Mary Beth Lofgren, one of the three Utah products here from the state of Utah on the Utah team.
She has a career high of 9 points. And, you know, when you're not giving tenths away on the landings like they have in the last couple meets, that really does wonders for your vault score at the end of the rotation. Here's the round off back handspring. Full, a little bit pike down, but, boy, that's the definition of a stick right there. That is solid. She just needs to get a little more block before she twists so she doesn't have to pike down quite so much.
Nicole Pachanik now for Stanford, next up on the bars.
Beautiful release move between high and low bar. The gymnast must change bars twice during the routine. This is her second release. Those are called transitional moves, and they move between the two bars. Double layout, and another just a half a tenth on the small hop on the landing.
And we'll take a break and be right back with more of this Utah versus Stanford College Gymnastics meet right after this. Huntsman Center, everyone. Freshman Nancy Domanova up next for the University of Utah on the vault.
Career best of 9.85. Round off back handspring layout full. This was a little more stretch before the landing, but that score-wise will be canceled out by the hop when she came down. Here we see good tight back handspring. A really good block off the horse before the twist, the hop backwards.
Christina Vakulik up next for Stanford. Pretty good bar set the Cardinal have going for them so far.
Well, I'm not surprised. They really were on the money in warm-ups. The release says we haven't seen the best routines yet. Saving them for the end of the lineup, hoping to maximize the scores based on the previous routines. There's a clear hip heck to high bar. And a half pirouette. Now we'll see what she can do. Okay, that was just quick thinking on her feet. No, she turned a potential fall into something with basically no deductions by doing that extra giant half. And in fact, she added to the difficulty of the routine with it.
Did not quite get the vertical on the handstand.
That can be
still
a tenth off for every 10 degrees out of handstands. And that, you know, she just really deserves a lot of credit for that. She easily could have cast it over and jumped off the bar.
Freshman Corey Lothrop being billed as the future of Utah Gymnastics. She is a good one.
The round off back handspring layout full. Again, the hot. Now she got really good rock also. She's higher than some of the other gymnasts. But until they start to get a little bit more stretched in the air and completely hold a tight layout position, they're going to be hopping backwards. Versus is not the time of the season that you're worrying too much about sticks. That comes halfway through because it can take its toll on the ankles. So as long as the gymnasts aren't landing short, yes, it's nice to stick. But really, you got to be careful because stuck landings can make some jammed, make a some jammed ankles sometimes.
Stanford, Elise Ishino.
Elise Ishino up next for Stanford.
She has a season best and a career best of 9.925.
One of the senior leaders on the Stanford team.
There's the clear hip heck to high bar to immediate shoot half. Absolutely perfect handstand positions. notice her completely locked out elbows. Perfect toe point, a piked Jaeger, absolutely beautiful. A little bit out of handstand at the end of that half pirouette. And dismount, double layout, and a hop on the landing.
Stephanie McAllister now in the cleanup spot for Utah on the vault.
There's a layout full, and again, a sizable hop back. She just needs to block and let the vault rise a split second longer before coming into the twist. You can see she's already turned while her hands are still on the horse. Otherwise, very good, very solid. Pike down. Pretty large hop on the landing.
Stephanie in the sixth position for Utah because Kendall Robarts, as we mentioned, injured her knee in warm-ups at Nebraska last week. And Stanford's final competitor on the bars, Alyssa Brown, a junior out of Ontario, Canada.
Also a 9.9 performer. There's a toe-on, toe-off, hex to high bar, into a pack salto, named after the first Korean gymnast to perform it. Dismount sequence, a Tkachev, named after the first Russian gymnast to perform it on the men's high bar. Two giants to a double layout, and there is another solid landing. That will be a fantastic score for Stanford.
Alyssa Brown, the junior, the final competitor on the bars for Stanford. We're going to total up the first round rotation and be back with the results right after this. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. Utah versus Stanford in women's college gymnastics. Missy Marlowe alongside Wesley Ruff. And Utah has the lead after the first rotation, 49.275 to 49.150. Utah looked pretty good.
They looked really good. They had a couple of large hops on the landings, but they also had a few really good sticks. So overall, very encouraging. Five freshmen, as we said. That's a situation that is extremely rare in for any team in college gymnastics.
Earlier this week, we talked with co-head coach Megan Marston, and she talked about the freshmen who performed well, but not superb yet, and she was hoping for the freshmen to start making that jump up into that upper elite level.
We continue to have some things to tweak in their routines. They're all doing a nice job of hitting their events and staying on the equipment, but at the moment we're not scoring a lot of 9.9s, and so there's still some things to fix, some different maybe little adjustments we might do with, you know, some of the choice selection on elements, leaps, and then continuing to tell them, you know, the way they need to do their routine to get the judges' attention for the big scores.
Of course, Utah will continue to upgrade its routines throughout the season, trying to get those bigger scores. For right now, we've moved at the second rotation. Stanford has moved to the vault, and Utah will be on the bars. First up on the vault for Stanford is Danielle Ikoma.
It's a layout full and a fantastic stick to start. Again, not completely, totally stretched in the air, but a really solid vault. She had good height and she had good distance.
Freshman Nancy Daminova up on the bars for Utah.
A Canadian Olympian in Beijing. Her season high so far is a 9.75.
Out of Bulgaria, moved to Canada and competed in the Olympics.
Here's her dismount sequence. Toe on, toe off. Blind half to a double front, a very, very difficult dismount to stick. I competed in Bulgaria when I was 14
really?
Years old. I did.
Nice.
It was quite an experience.
14-year-old going to Europe.
Next
not
up,
a bad gig.
Communist Europe back in those days. I'll never forget it.
Nicole Dayton now on the vault for the Stanford Cardinal.
This will be a layout with a half twist, the forward landing, and really solid. She turned right in the middle when she's supposed to and is completely and totally stretched before hitting the ground. Just a step on the landing.
Looked like she almost stepped sideways on that landing.
Well, she was a little bit off, which can be an additional deduction on the step.
Mary Beth Lofgren, one of the hometown girls here for the Utes.
This is her first competition on bars.
working the all-around tonight for the first time this season.
There's a full and a half pirouette to a straddleback handstand. Good handstand position on the bar. A Tkachev. Just needs to wind up. A great debut here on bars and a double layout. Just a little bit piped down and just tried to cover those couple steps on the landing. But a good start on bars for Mary Beth.
In your first routine, aren't you just a little quicker than you need to be and just trying to get that done and make no mistakes?
She's just
and get
a
out?
Touch sloppy, a little bit piked on the first somersault and then a little bit straddled with her legs on the second. And again, she pulls up as fast as possible and salutes the judge.
Next up.
Elise Ichino ready to go on the vault for the Cardinal.
This is a layout full. And a good walk off the horse. She got a good rise and a good pop before pulling into the twist. Just a slight pike down and a fairly sizable hop on landing.
Courtney Beers now ready to go on the bars for the University of Utah.
She's had a career best of 9.9, although she struggled on bars this season, scoring an 8.6 against Georgia and a 9.15 against Nebraska. So far moving smoothly. There's a toe-on, toe-off to a pack salto. Half pirouette. Two giant swings to a double layout. Little bit of a form break. A stuck hold landing. Now remember, the judges are sitting to the side, so the gymnast straddles her legs. It's not really visible. Double layout, solid landing.
Courtney Beers with an outstanding effort on the bars for Utah. We'll take a quick timeout and be back with more of this meet right after this. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. The Stanford Cardinal on the vault. This is Ashley Morgan getting ready to compete.
This is another layout with a half twist. And a large step. Actually, that really kind of turned into three steps by the time she actually brought her feet back together. Just overshot that landing. It was a good vault. It was nice and high, and it had a lot. You can't say too much pop because you'll never go too high and you'll never go too far, but she did have a hard time controlling it when her feet came down.
Jill Mackey now on the bars for Utah.
There's an eagle grip to a front pike Jaeger. Shoot half to handstand. Remember, the routine started a 9.5, and they earned their way up to a 10.0 start value, both by individual difficulty of the skills and by combinations done together in a row. And that was an absolutely perfect dismount.
Courtney Beers, one of the best bar workers on this Utah team, and she shows why here tonight.
Double layout, completely stretched, solid landing, and she has every reason to be happy about that. This is a layout with a full twist.
Shelly Alexander set to go on the vault.
Vault is named a Yurchenko after Natalia Yurchenko, one of the most popular Soviet gymnasts ever. And just done nicely. She got great height, great distance. About a half a tenth on the landing. Her feet came up off the mat, although she really didn't move from where she landed, so not a full tenth on the landing.
Corey Lothrop set to go on the bars for Utah.
He has a season best of 9.8 so far.
She has hit all 12 of her routines so far this year.
There's a blind full pirouette finish just a little bit out of the handstand. The blind half to a Jaeger. Slightest arch on the handstand on high bar. Double layout and a hop forward on the landing. Just a few little form breaks. Not so much with her legs, but just a touch of arched handstands during that routine.
At practice earlier this week, Megan Marsden talked about using these four home meets to clean up stuff like that. Get ready for the regionals and nationals coming up later this year.
Next up,
Alyssa Brown, Stanford's final competitor on the vault.
She has a career best of 9.925 and a season best of 9.875. This is a Yurchenko, full twist. And you know, what she did well on that vault is she stayed completely and totally stretched until she hit the ground. There was no piking down.
Stephanie McAllister now on the bars for Utah. She's currently 10th in the nation in this event.
You know, she has a career best of 9.925. Pretty high score for being 10th in the country. A half in, half out, or a full twisting double back. A little bit off balance on the landing. She pulled her feet through just a little bit too far, had all the weight on her heels, had to take two steps backwards.
All right, we are halfway through this meet between Stanford and Utah. We're going to take a timeout, come back with the third rotation right after this. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center. We are halfway through this meet between second-ranked Stanford and fourth-ranked Utah, and the Stanford Cardinal has taken the lead here, Missy.
Well, barely.
Barely.
0.025 is what we have going into beam and floor. It'll be fun.
98.350 for Utah, 98.375 for Stanford. Stanford looked pretty good on the vault.
They look great on the vault. Both teams had some really good stuck landings. Utah had a few, not big breaks, but just little tiny, little bit of arching handstands here and there. You know, that type of thing, nothing that isn't easy to fix. Utah's been fantastic on beam this season, so this will be a good event.
And this is the first of four straight home meets for the University of Utah. And according to Stephanie McAllister, there's no place like home.
It feels good. It feels good that we'll be here for a couple weeks. I think 3 or 4 weeks we'll be home, which is nice because the Huntsman is just like such a great atmosphere with our fans and our people, and it's just, it'll be good.
And Utah would like nothing better than to send this hometown crowd home with a victory. And in all likelihood, it will be won or lost here on the beam, as meets so often are. Utah starting out with Femina Kobayashi on the beam.
Femina is very, very good on the beam. However, she had a little bit of a hard time in the 30-second touch. But slipped on the back handspring, and she came down a little bit hard on the layout. So she needs to keep her head on straight here, stay concentrated. Here's her tumbling series. Back handspring step out, layout step out, and nicely done. I've known Femina since, and she came off on the front aerial. Not what she was probably worried about after getting the back handspring layout out of the way. Starting out with a fallen beam is a tough situation for the remaining five competitors. I was saying I've known Femina since she was 7 years old. She's a local product in every sense of the word. Round off, double twist, good landing, half a tenth. Starting with a fall.
All kinds of pressure now on the University of Utah.
And there's this tumbling skill that she had a hard time with in warm-ups. A good dismount, small step on the landing.
Stanford will be on the floor during this rotation. Leading the way, Danielle Ikoma.
Opening tumbling run, almost always the hardest pass. Ooh, and a little bit of a low landing on the double pike. She already has one ankle taped. That can be really painful if your ankles are sore. Some really powerful music.
It's aggressive.
A little tumbling run, whip half to front layout, front layout. There's bonus in the combination on that pass. Any leaps or jumps that have a full turn in them are also difficult enough to get bonus on. There's a scissor side half turn. A
Danielle, one of three gymnasts working the all-around for Stanford here tonight.
Final tumbling run, round off back handspring, tuck double back, and she holds on to that well. Still a little bit low. Pretty big knee bend. Pretty squatted on the landing.
Next up on beam for Utah, Gail Mackey.
Yeah, if there's not enough pressure on Utah on the beam anyway now. With Femina's fall, Gail Mackey.
Well, and Gail can be a great, great beam worker, but she's a little bit inconsistent. So far, she has a 9.85 this year for her career best. This season, she's gone 9.15 and a 9.6. So they're going to need to get back up into the 9.9 range at this point. There's a good back handspring layout step out. Now, if Utah wants to regain this lead, especially with a fall in the first competitor, they cannot give away 1 2/10 wobbles or steps at this point.
She had a pretty nice routine going right up until that balance check.
Next up on floor for Stanford, Nicole Dayton.
Nicole Dayton, a sophomore out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Next up on the floor.
Handspring, tuck double back. A little bit of a stumble with the back foot. It's not a deduction to use that mat as long as you see the white lines on it so the judges know if the gymnast went out of bounds.
That mat's used to help soften the landings, correct?
Yep, you can see her ankles are taped, so she's probably trying to protect ankles or the shins. Front layout, front layout. Tergitate half to a straddle full. Skills in gymnastics are rated from an A to an E, depending on difficulty.
Which is the highest, A or E?
E is the highest. Round off full and a half twist to punch front a little bit sloppy with her legs in the air on the full and a half.
Nicole Dayton.
That's Nicole Dayton for Stanford.
Next up on beam for Utah, Stephanie McAllister.
Stephanie McAllister, the junior, second team All-American for the Utes.
Her career best of 9.8 came this year against Georgia. Tumbling, the gymnasts are allowed a 1 second concentration pause. Back handspring, back handspring, layout, step out.
Perfect.
Done perfectly. Straddle jump, quarter turn. Every time the gymnast splits, it must be a complete 180 degree split.
And where is head coach Greg Marsden during all of this?
He's in the TV room, probably watching basketball.
Up the tunnel.
I always thought that was a joke until I saw him in there one time.
Great routine by Stephanie McAllister.
Scott double twist, and boy, did they need that. A fantastic comeback for the Utes after a fall in the first routine.
And hopefully that will set the plate for the final three competitors on the beam for Utah. Clutch performance by the junior.
There's a double twist to an excellent landing.
Next up on the floor for Stanford, Elise Ishino.
Elise Ishino up next on the floor for Stanford.
She has a career best of a 9.9 that came this season at their Pac-10 showcase.
She is leading the all-around competition here tonight so far.
Whip, punch full, and half punch layout. You know, she was in trouble right from the start on that.
Short on the landing?
She just didn't have much power coming out of the whip into the full and a half. Scissor ring leap. The gymnast must touch the back of their head with their foot in order to get full credit.
I'm sorry, what?
Well, let's just say it has to be head height. The complete extension through the chest and the head must actually snap backwards.
Sounds like a headache waiting to happen right there.
Some gymnasts can actually do that on the balance beam.
Wow. Setting up for a final tumbling run.
Round off back handspring, pike double back.
Elise Ishino.
Solid routine for Stanford.
Elise Ishino on the floor for Stanford. We're going to take a break, come back with the final three competitors on each event in just a minute. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. Courtney Beers now on the beam for the University of Utah. The Utes started with a fall on this apparatus, so they need clean routines now to have any chance of catching or surpassing second-ranked Stanford.
There's a front aerial. That's a front walkover with no hands. Courtney's career best of 9.825 came against UCLA this year in the season opener. Back handspring, layout, step out. The Utes have upgraded some of their tumbling combinations to the three skill series. Split jump, double stag jump. That's required to do two dance skills connected in a row. So far, the Utes coming back strong. The side aerial, that's a cartwheel with no hands. Side scale. And the dismount cartwheel, swing through full and a solid landing.
Nice routine.
Beautiful
by
routine
Beers.
By Courtney.
That's two clutch performances for Utah and they need it right now.
Back handspring, layout, step out. Just a tenth on the landing. Cartwheel swing through full. Half a tenth on the foot slide on the landing.
Nicole Pachanik set to go for Stanford. Next year, these two teams will be in the same conference. They'll be in the Pac-12 together.
You know, it's funny to talk about conferences. It just doesn't mean that much
in
to gymnasts.
Yep.
Everything, what it will do is it will add a neat component to regular season that isn't there right now for the youths. But everything really does come down to regionals and nationals in gymnastics. Round off back handspring, triple twist, middle tumbling run. She is extremely flexible, absolutely beautiful, fully extended leaps, completely split. very powerful style of dance. The routines, even despite the different music, they all have a pretty similar strength in their execution. Front handspring, front layout, front full.
Stanford looking pretty solid so far on the floor.
Well, she just did not give the judges any deductions. That was a fantastic floor routine.
Nicole Titanic. She's happy about it.
Next up on beam for Utah, Corey Lobroff.
Final two competitors on the beam for Utah will be freshmen. Corey Lothrop, ready to go.
Her career best is a 9.85 against Nebraska. Switchley, straddle quarter. Side aerial switch. She is the first gymnast to have ever performed that move. Back handspring step out, layout step out, solid landing. You know, and really the fall on the lead competitor, in some ironic ways, it's almost a blessing in disguise because the next five athletes, four so far, have gotten up and really shown the coaches that they're not fazed by the pressure. They know the entire competition's on the line, and so far they've really knocked out these routines. That's very encouraging for Megan Marsden to see. Full and a half twist, and again that hop on the landing. This meet could come down to 10. They need to stick the beam dismounts.
It's the tiniest of hops, but still, it's a 10th, right?
It's a 10th.
Next up on floor for Stanford, Shelly Alexander.
Shelly Alexander now on the floor for Stanford.
Career best of 9.9 and a season high of 9.85. Opening tumbling run, round off back handspring, pike double back. Not some of the harder tumbling that we will see later on. A lot of teams ranked in the top five or top 10 will have some double layouts or some full twisting double backs like the Utes have. But it is early in the season. Full and a half twist to front layout. Stanford has a really good performance quality about their routines. They're not overly concentrated. I know this is
it. It's a little jazzier than the last couple we've heard from Stanford. Solid performance by Shelly.
For the last tumbling run, round off that handspring, tuck double back, and again, just really, really clean routines.
It's impressive.
Shelly Alexander. Next up on beam for Utah, Mary Beth Lofgren.
Mary Beth Lofgren in the anchor position for Utah. Because of that injury to Kendall Robarts. He's a freshman from right here in Utah.
Trained with Mary Wright and Ryan Kirkham at Olympus Gymnastics in Sandy. And the coaches just can't say enough good things about Mary Beth and the way that she's come in and handled her freshman year. There is absolutely no waiting to become a sophomore or junior or senior. She's really taken the season by storm. She had a little bit of form breaks, a little bit of a bent back knee on that back handspring layout step out. Side aerial.
They must have all kinds of confidence in her if she's in the anchor spot here.
Yeah, it's very unusual to have a freshman anchoring an event. And that move, she needed to hold that scale a bit longer, but that was actually made famous by Nastia Lukin in the last Olympics. Cartwheel, swing through full, and another great landing. Boy, you know, part of her success is she just isn't giving away a temp here or a temp there on anything.
Very nice performance by Mary Beth.
Just like her vault, you see the back leg is a little bit sloppy with her knee and her foot. And a cartwheel swing through full, a little bit piked in the air also. But just an awesome landing. And, you know, the Utes responded. I mean, I don't think the coaches could ask for any more.
Ashley Morgan will be the final competitor on the floor for the Cardinal here tonight.
She's had 9.925s in both of their competitions, the Pac-10 Showcase and UCLA.
Hear the crowd responding to the score for Mary Beth Loughran.
And there's an Arabian double front. Beautiful leaps and jumps. Second tumbling run, front handspring, front layout, within the limits of the floor, and a top double back. And again, that's the fourth routine in a row where they just, not the hardest tumble we've seen, but fantastic dance, excellent leaps and jumps, and just simply no deductions for the judges to take.
There is a reason Stanford is number two in the country. They are showing why here tonight. We'll come back with a final rotation. Utah will move to the floor. Stanford to the beam. We'll have that coming up right after this. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. You know, Missy Marlowe, we talked about at the top of the show that we expected a great meet. We've got one here tonight. The score is tied after three rotations, 147.5 to 147.5.
I guess you can't ask for more than that, huh? I think the fans got their money's worth. I think they did.
So far, there's 13,000 here tonight in the Huntsman Center. Ashley Morgan with a 9.925 in the anchor position on the floor for Stanford.
Well, they had some fantastic floor routines. I mean, there wasn't a lot for the judges to deduct on. Some of the scores are actually maybe half a tenth lower than what I would have thought. And Utah coming back after a fall on the first competitor on beam to just doing the five best routines that they could do. I mean, that is a tough situation to be in, and they handled it like pros.
Absolutely. Mary Beth Loughran with a 9.9 in the anchor position, her first time ever in the anchor spot on the beam. So Utah, Stanford tied heading into the final rotation. It will be Stanford on the beam, Utah on the floor, and we expect, with 13,000 fans here, Utah to just pull out all the stops and go for it here.
Well, they're certainly in a more enviable position than Stanford is.
Alyssa Brown up on the lead-up position for Stanford on the beam. And Missy, it's going to be interesting to see how they handle the pressure and the crowd here, because I don't think they've competed in front of anything even close to this.
Well, their last home competition
fans
drew 1,100 people. So, yeah, this is a little bit different.
Over 13,000 here tonight in the Huntsman Center.
You know, I predict that they will do good beam routines. I mean, they're just a strong team. They're well-coached, obviously, and they're tough mentally. But I think probably 9 out of 10 of us old former gymnasts would tell you they'd rather be on floor right now than beam right now. That was a beautiful back handspring layout step out. So switch leg leap to one arm back handspring. That needs to be completely directly connected and not broken up by an extra arm swing. Kick over front.
She's been pretty solid so far.
So far, a really solid routine. It's moving just a little bit slowly. Second switch leg leap. Into the dismount, a full. And again, you know, they just really are playing the rule, but they're doing what they need to do. They're not doing more than what they need to do. And they are just aren't giving the judges any deductions.
Freshman Leah Del Piore on the floor for Utah.
She has only competed floor once for Utah. That was against Nebraska, and she scored a 9.475. To it well, didn't lose any extra tenths through steps, but definitely in the height of that landing. She's from Parquette's Gymnastics in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Front layout and floor, or excuse me, Stanford put up a 9.85 on their first beam routine. So it makes it pretty easy to follow the scores when they go inside.
This is going to be tight.
Next round off back handspring, tuck double back. There's the first tumbling run.
Elisa Shino now on the beam, still leading the all around competition here tonight.
Her season best so far is a 9.75. She has scored as high as a 9.9. So opening, tumbling pass, back handspring step out, layout step out. Required leaper jump combination.
That beam, we'll remind everyone, just 4 inches wide. Not a lot of room for error.
No room for error. Side summy. Leach is a senior out of Santa Ana, California. And a gainer layout, just a slight one-tenth wobble. Switch leap to gainer full off the side. And I think they came here to try to knock off the Utes.
I think you may be right.
They've got a great battle. Next
up, Mary Beth Loughran coming off that great performance on the beam. Up next on the floor for Utah.
So Mary Beth's fun facts are that she is obsessed with shoes and has never, ever eaten a pickle. Beautiful pike double back.
No pickles, hamburgers, nothing. That's
what she says. My five-year-old has clung to that fact. I can't tell you how many times in my kitchen, out of the blue, she says, Mary Beth has never eaten a pickle. Don't you love it?
I wonder what that was a goal she had as a kid. You know what? I'm going to go my whole life and never eat a pickle.
I love pickles myself. Round off. Whip, punch, double full, little bit off center, although it wasn't low, not really off balance.
Beth working the all-around for the first time ever here tonight.
Taking a breath before our final tumbling run. Front handspring, 1.5 to layout step out. And trying to answer routine for routine. And that is Amy Trepanier's old final pose.
She probably watched Amy Trepanier do that as a kid.
There's the pike double back. Front handspring, 1.5 to layout. You know, she almost stuttered, stepped a little bit, but she had so much power, she was able to make the layout pretty easily.
Christina Vakulik next up on the beam for the Cardinal.
Switch leap, standing back tuck. Oh, and she did a good job. Her left foot was pretty far off the side. Full twisting swing down. Done extremely well.
Kind of had the feeling she was in trouble after that first wobble.
Here's her tumbling series. Required combination. Handspring step out, layout step out. Scissor side leap. Switch leg leap. Sassone. Just a few little teeny tiny balance errors. There's a side aerial, oh, and a fall. You know, this really is a packed routine. Very friendly crowd at Utah Center. Best wishes for last and a round off double back, a very, very difficult beam dismount. But not the routine that Stanford hoped to put up.
Next up on floor for Utah, Nancy Damianova.
Nancy Damianova now up on the floor for the Red Rocks. And their scores on the floor so far, Missy, have been lower than Stanford's were.
So Nancy says she used to do balance beam on the edge of the bathtub and used baby powder as chalk. Tuck double back. Ooh, and almost out of bounds, but not over the line. You know, baby powder is slippery. She must really be brave.
And if you miss on the tub, ow.
That's a slippery surface.
In the Olympics in Beijing, China. You were in the Olympics in Seoul?
Seoul, Korea. You can hear the crowd giving some encouragement. So far, score for score, Stanford is leading. Round off back handspring, high double back, beautiful landing.
See Megan Marston in the background. Excited about that.
You know, you're just so out of control as a coach. All you can do is cheer and hope.
Nancy Demanova, third competitor on the floor for Utah. We'll take a quick break. Be back with the final three competitors on each rotation right after this quick timeout. Welcome back to the Huntsman Center, everyone. We have a meet here between second-ranked Stanford and fourth-ranked Utah. Ashley Morgan on the beam for the Cardinal.
Season best of 9.85 so far. She scored that twice at the Pac-10 Showcase and against UCLA. Back handspring, step out, layout, step out. And she also had a little bit of a form break with her back right knee on the back handspring and the layout. Split jump, split full, very difficult dance combination.
The Stanford team is awfully impressive.
They really are. They're very, very consistent. Punch front. Beautiful, Andy. And the judges are looking for exactly what she did, which is almost straight up and down, not landing in a lower squat. The dismount round off, tuck double back again, and a large step on the dismount. Now they don't need to compete dismounts that difficult in order to have their start values at a 10.0. And as the season goes on, if they're losing a tenth on their landings, they're going to need to reevaluate that.
Stephanie McAllister, the junior for the University of Utah, next competitor on the floor. The nickname is Happy, and you can see why.
Opening tumbling run. Round off back handspring. Full twisting double back. That's the hardest pass we've seen so far tonight. More important than ever to keep these routines clean. It cannot afford a break. 2.5 twist to front tackle, and she almost looked from this angle like she could have gone out of bounds, but really wasn't even close. Clean landing. Final tumbling run. 2.5 twist to a beautiful layout step out. And putting the pressure on Stanford, that switch leap needed to be a little bit more split. The gymnast must show 180.
Great routine by Stephanie McAllister.
Round off back handspring, full twisting double back. Now she wants to step back out of it, not forward, but really not a deduction, and a gorgeous last pass.
Not enough O's and smooth for that last pass. Shelly Alexander next up on the beam for Stanford. Both teams have had a fall on the beam, but neither team so far has had to count a fall.
That handspring layout step out. You know, the judges are keeping the floor scores pretty tight. Stanford's weren't quite as high as I maybe would have thought they would have been, but then now neither are Utah's.
Yeah.
There's a switch leg leap, standing back tuck, little balance check. Dismount, round off, double twist. Oh, and a large direction problem and a large step on the landing.
She's been so solid right
up until leaves the door open.
Freshman Corey Lothrop ready to go on the floor.
And Utah is petitioning the floor score for Stephanie McAllister, it looks like, or quite possibly Mary Bath or Nancy. Megan handed a paper to the meet referee. Round off back handspring, another full twisting double back. Perfectly executed. Second tumbling run. Full and a half twist to front layout.
They knew she would be good when they recruited her. She has not disappointed so far this season.
An Olympic team alternate. Round off back handspring, pike double back. Oh, and an out of bounds, and the Utes cannot afford that.
Wow.
She just pulled her feet underneath her a little bit too much. Here's the first tumbling pass, a full twisting double back. Done as well as it can be done.
Next up, on for Stanford.
And you know that's gonna come back and haunt them.
Well, you know, the neat thing about tonight is that both teams have done such a good job. I mean, you know, last week they went to Nebraska and Nebraska completely, totally fell apart on being just handed the meet to them. So, you know, it doesn't really give you a good indication of where you are with the other top teams. If the team, you know, has a bad event. And so far, this is an excellent contest between these two teams.
Which is what you want as a coach, too. You want your gymnasts competing against the best.
Well, absolutely.
And doing their best.
And I don't think either team, they were both well aware they had to come in and have great competitions in order to win. There are no illusions about that.
Danny Ikoma on the beam, final competitor for Stanford.
Back handspring step out, layout step out. 1/10 balance check. Scissor side half, extremely difficult leap.
If she holds on to this routine, I think it's going to be impossible for Utah to catch Stanford.
Round off, tuck, double back, one step on the landing. And yeah, they have really gotten up and just knocked those beam routines out. They're competing with a lot of poise. They don't seem at all fazed by pressure or the crowd.
They've already recorded a couple of 9-9s on the beam. Final competitor of the night. It's Gail Mackey for the Utes on the floor.
First tumbling run, a pike double back. Full and a half twist, a front layout, a little bit low on the layout, but she had plenty of power to pull it around. Stephanie McAllister's floor routine that the coaches are protesting.
How How tired are the gymnasts by the time that final tumbling run comes up?
Well, it's pretty tiring, much more so than you'd think. It's basically a 90-second full sprint. Of course, they do take little pauses in the dance and the music, but the energy that's spent on those tumbling passes is just incredible.
And there is Gail Mackey's final tumbling run of the night.
It's their first competition for the Utes on floor, a whip to a punch full twist. She has a career best of 9.8. We'll see if this can be her new career best tonight. Gorgeous ending pose.
The crowd liked it. All concentration on her face.
Handspring pike double back, first pass. Round off whip, full, a little bit piked on the full.
All right, we're going to add up the scores, come back with the final totals right after this. Sportsman Center, everyone, Utah versus Stanford in women's college gymnastics, and Missy Marlowe, we expected a great meet, and we certainly got one here tonight.
We got a great meet, not as good as we wanted, but it's pretty good.
The hometown fans, 13,000 plus, going home a little disappointed tonight because Utah on the short end of the score. Utah had a season high 196.5, but it was not enough. Stanford with a 196.825, the Stanford Cardinal, number two ranked team in the country.
And to this point in the season, that's the highest score that's been scored. They just beat Florida previous high of 196.708. So as the scores come in tonight, tomorrow, over the weekend, it'll be neat to see how things shake out.
Stanford, very impressive. They were solid. They weren't exactly spectacular, but they did what they needed to do, and they were solid throughout this meet.
They were. You know, and Utah did, too. I mean, competing an entire lineup of freshmen is a pretty unusual situation. And, you know, they came through really, really well, but you can't say enough about what those extra 2 or 3 years in competition do for a team. And, you know, it's going to be really neat to see this team continue to grow and continue to build, because really, I mean, they're young. They're babies in terms of college competition. So it's neat to see them really come together and rally and be able to put great competitions together.
Kind of thrown into the fire in this meet because they had some seniors, Kendall Robarts, Jacqueline Johnson, not competing because of injuries. So the freshmen had to step up. They did a great job, as we mentioned, a season high for Utah, just not quite enough against Stanford.
No, and I think they're going to be disappointed because, you know, when you have your season high, you kind of hope that it's going to be enough to do it. You know, this is a neat place to compete. I'm sure Stanford's thrilled with themselves. 13,000 plus people, you know, we're also competing against the Utah Jazz, the Grizzlies tonight. That just shows you what this community feels about gymnastics.
Absolutely.
And I just think it's really neat.
All right, Utah has three more home meets coming up in a row. Our next televised meet will be against Michigan on February 18th, and that will be broadcast on ABC4 on February 20th, Sunday at 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. And don't forget, coming up tonight at 10:30 on ABC4, it's the Red Zone with head coach Jim Boylan. For Missy Marlowe, our entire crew here at the Huntsman Center, we want to thank you for tuning in. I'm Wes LaRuff. Good night, everybody.